Late. A little higher, honey, up to his forehead. That's good.
Scene 5, A and B, take 1.
That you have never, ever looked lovelier.
I wish I'd said that. Only the worthy.
You can get cleaned up now. We thankfully will not need you anymore today.
Free, free. Well, underpaid anyway.
Save the key light. That was really great, guys.
How'd it sound, Bill?
I think it's good, thing. Thanks.
Jesus, that was pathetic. To make a note, gonna mat in John Cleese and a dancing bear behind that sequence.
Miss Gordon.
You know, ha-ha, and like that.
Sire, you know, it's not really nice to pick on the child. She is new here. She's not expected to know when you're joking.
As the bishop said to the actress.
Besides, I just wrote it down myself.
But the boy's right, my child, my child.
No denying this, no.
No, indeed, no. I shouldn't even expect you, in a wholesome innocence.
Expect.
The wonderfulness of your ways.
Wonderful.
The true tyroity of yourself.
Tyroity, in fact, yes.
Tyroity of yourself.
Yes, yes.
To fathom the bizarre and
indeed.
Twisted ways of show business.
However, if you would like a little instruction, I'm not doing anything tonight.
Oh, that's too bad. You'll probably be so lonely.
Yes. Welcome again, my friends, to the Comedy Shop, where anyone could be the next Steve Martin and Lewis, Steve Allen and Rossi.
Not Dan and Ed.
Hmm?
No, no, no. Places, everybody. We still got those inserts to do. Let's get that camera moved. Gaffers, hello. I want those lights switching. Oh, very good.
We better beat him over there, because this is my favorite shot. I get to shoot him.
I thought you were Sound of Music.
Sweetheart, you do have a lot to learn.
Action. William?
Yeah, I'm here, sir.
Okay, then. Check out a light at the end. Who loaded this iron?
Jesus, sire, I'm sorry. You know, I always check my own loads, almost.
I loaded the gun. What happened?
This little baby nearly spoiled a take. Are you sure you loaded the gun properly?
Sure, 6 cartridges, all from the same box. The hollow-nose 22s with the low-velocity shells, just like always.
Well, this little baby is nice and solid and hit me at about 0.5 mile a second. Are you sure none of the bullets look different?
As sure as I can be.
Was the gun left unattended?
I left it on the prop truck. Never had any trouble before.
Okay, Frog, thanks. It's not your responsibility. That's a wrap, folks. I guess it must have just been some kind of error.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, somebody must have dropped a heavy-duty slug in with the specials.
Yeah, well, you know, I never question your judgment, sir. But there are some people who would ask why you use live ammo at all. We got these guys up in effects, you know.
It's a question of authenticity.
Mm.
Uh-huh. No, the camera may not see the actual bullets, but it does see the impact. No, I mean, those things hit me, and it bounced and it hit the floor. Everything's dandy. It really does look better.
I know it does. Huh?
Okay.
Just a minute. You mean to tell me those were real bullets? I mean, I was scared enough at the last one, but if I thought they were all real,
What banana boat did you get off of? You are new here, aren't you?
Well, Miss Lockwood hired me 2 weeks ago after you promoted her. But this is my first day working with you, sir.
Sire, Miss Gordon. I can see that there are a few things I better explain to you.
Thank you, sire. I'm sure that will help.
No, no. Don't get him started again. If I hear this story one more time, I'm transferring to the animated cartoon department.
Surely, a comic book or something.
Well, I've been shown a couple of funny books, but it seems so incredible. I knew they were just stories.
Ah, but they're not. Every comic book adventure you've read about me is based in fact.
You mean you really bounce those bullets off your chest? You mean you really vanish and reappear just like that?
Miss Gordon! Over here!
What kept you?
Oh. You can play your games and be as clever as you like, but this is where I wanted you.
You'll save yourself a lot of trouble if you just,
Trouble? Hey, I've got time. Take them.